हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द पार्ट टू ऑफ अ चैप्टर थ्री, फाइबर टू फैब्रिक. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज फाइबर, व्हाट इज यार्न, व्हाट इज नेचुरल फाइबर, व्हाट इज सिंथेटिक फाइबर, एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द सम एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस फाइबर्स. इन टूडेज लेक्चर और इन टूडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंट प्लांट्स फाइबर. As we have already discussed in objectives, that this chapter is focused on only natural fibers. So, we are going to learn about some natural fibers. Where does it grow? Which state it grow? How it grow? Okay? So, let's start the next topic. The next topic is plant fibers, in which they have given the first fiber is cotton. So I just want you to give a simple task. Just look around you and make a list of things which are made up of cotton. In your book they have given cotton wool, means cotton is used to make mattresses, that is nothing but gadda. Then quilts are nothing but blankets and pillow. So the cotton is used to make quilts, mattresses and pillows. In the next paragraph they are saying take a cotton wool. So let's take a cotton wool. Can everybody see the cotton wool? If we separate this, so now please look at this little strands, these threads are nothing but cotton fibers. Using this cotton fiber they have made entire cotton. So these little strands are nothing but cotton fiber. Okay students, so students, where does this cotton wool come from or where does it grow? It grows in a fields. It has large farms for their growth. The best suitable condition to grow a cotton plant is the soil should be black and the climate should be warm. The places which has black soil and warm climate are mostly suitable for the growth of cotton plants. Okay students, in our country, in India, there are some states which are famous for cotton, such as Gujarat, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu. If you want to write, please write it down, because in your textbook it is not given. So the state in which cotton grows are Gujarat, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh. Okay, just write down in your textbook. Okay students, so the next topic is cotton balls. So if anyone ask what is cotton ball, or there might be question in your assignment, what is cotton balls? So the cotton balls is nothing but the fruit of the cotton plants. If you saw a cotton plant, it has a beautiful fruit. So this fruit is nothing but cotton balls. Have you seen the cotton fields? It is given in your textbook, page number 20, figure number 3.6. The field of cotton plants are given. They are adorable, gorgeous to look. Okay, if you may get chance, please visit such a fields of cotton. Okay students, these cotton balls, that is the fruits of cotton plants, are the size of lemon. They are just like a lemon, and as they mature, that means as they grow, these lemons or fruit of the cotton plants, that is cotton balls, burst, they pop up and cotton will be visible. Okay, as they have said, the balls burst open and the seeds cover of a cotton fiber can be seen. You can see these types of cotton in that particular cotton plant. Okay, the fruits, that is cotton ball, burst, that is food jate hai wo. Okay, and the cottons are easily visible. Okay, you can clearly see the cotton plant in the figure number 3.6. So the next topic is ginning. Ginning is the first and the simplest process in which fibers are separated from the respective plant parts. In cotton, they are separated from seeds. In earlier time, in older time, they used hands, hand picking it is called. They used hand to separate fibers from plant. Nowadays, there are machines. Okay, so the process of separation of fiber from seeds or plant parts is known as ginning. Let's repeat again. What is ginning? Ginning is the process of separation of fibers from the plant parts, or in our case it is seeds. Okay, so ginning is clear. It is the simplest one. The first process to make fiber to fabric. The first process to make fiber to fabric is ginning. Is it clear, students? As you can see in the figure number 3.7, a man is using comb. We used to make our hair using comb. Okay, and that is a small comb. But in the figure 3.7, it is a large comb that is used to separate cotton fiber which are burst from cotton balls. That cotton fibers are separated from their plants. Okay, as you can clearly see in the figure number 3.7. Okay, the next plant fiber is jute. Jute is obtained from stem of the plant. Stem is nothing but the trunk of the plant. In Gujarati, we called it thad. Okay, so jute is obtained from stem of the plant. It is cultivated, that means it grows in the rainy season. It grow in a rainy season, and there are some streets which are famous or popular for the growth or the cultivation of the jute, such as West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. Okay, in these states the jute is grown in a large amount. Is it clear? You may have asked question, in which state jute is grown? Okay, so you can write, it is West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. Okay, so let's see how jute is obtained from this jute plant. First, they gather the crops of jute plant in a flowering stage. It means when the plants are about to get flowered. Jab uske upar flower grow hone wala tha. At that time, they gather the plants. They put this plant in water for some days. After some days, these stems become loose, weak. They have used word rot. Rot means become loose or weak. So these stems become weak and the fiber is separated from the stems of the jute plant. Is it clear? It is a simple process. We have to separate jute fiber from the stem. So how to do it? You have to first gather the root. You have to first gather the jute plant. You have to dip this jute plant in a water for some days. After some days, when the stem become loose, you have to collect the jute fiber from the stems. Is it clear? So in the next step, how to make yarn form of fiber? As we have already seen while learning about the fiber, how to make yarn form of fiber. So let's see again. Okay, student. So to make yarn form the fiber, we have to first separate this fiber. Okay, so the process of separating fiber is known as ginning. So when the fibers are separated, how to make yarn from this fiber? So as you can see, I have different fibers in my hand. So if I take all the fibers like this, and if I start spinning these fibers or start rotating these fibers, can you see? These fibers are converted into yarn. We have already seen in the part 1 how we have separated fibers from yarn. Now we are making yarn using different fibers by combining different fibers. Is it clear? Okay. So the process of making yarn from the fiber is called spinning. In this process, the cotton fibers are drawn out and twisted. If we twist this cotton fibers, these cotton fibers are come together and form yarn. Is it clear, students? It's very simple. If we take more than 2 or 3 fiber and we twist like this, this twisting makes these fibers comes together, and this particular twisting of fibers make yarn. It is a conversion of fibers into yarn. Is it clear? It is very simple. Okay. Mahatma Gandhi has also encouraged to wear a clothes made up of this particular material that is known as khadi. Okay. So to popularize and to promote khadi, they have, the government of India constituted a body called Khadi and the Village Industries Commission in 1956. Okay. In 1956, they have promoted khadi as well as a Village Industries Commission. Is it clear? In older days, in earlier days, these two devices are used for spinning. But nowadays, there are machines available which are used to convert fiber into yarn. So now the yarn is created. So after this, we have to make fabric using this yarn. In the process of ginning, we have created or we have separated fibers. From that fibers, we have created yarn in the process of spinning. Now from yarn, we have to convert into clothes. So for converting into clothes or fabric, yarn to fabric or clothes, we have two method or two process. One is weaving and another is knitting. These two process we will see in the last part of this chapter, that is part 3. So we have to end this part. So in this part we have learned about two different types of plants fiber, that is first is cotton and jute. In both fiber we have seen how does it grow, where does it grow, okay, and we have also seen the process of ginning and spinning. We have also seen the devices used for spinning, that is takli or spindle and charkha. Is it clear, student? Watch this video. If you don't understand anything, please replay the video. And if you still do not understand anything, write down in the comment so we can explain it again. Okay. I hope you like the video. Okay. Thank you.